What's up, guys? Jay here, and as you can see, we have a new face guy. We have a new camera. Might need to actually adjust it while I'm here. No. Bam. There we go. Okay, so last week we had a few casualties. That being obviously Ember and Firefly. Anyway, obviously that's the bad result of the fact that I was relying on one Pokemon for this entire gym. Yeah, so let's go into it now. See what we can do about it. Now, I've done the best I can when it comes to prepping, and I do have a strategy, but first off, we need to get for the gym challenge. But luckily, it involves getting an encounter. You'll get more into details now about how it'll work. Ah, yes, it's Espresso Depresso. This is honestly nerve-wracking because I just don't have a certified way to beat this. Let's do this. Catching Pokemon. Basically, there are three Pokemon in this, in these bushes. What we need to do is get points. 2 points are from catching, 1 point is for defeating. So basically, for us to get past through Nuzlocke rules, we need to at least catch a 2. But due to Nuzlocke rules, and I've done research, the best way for me to do this is by capturing 2 and picking from that 2. So the first 2 we will bump into is what we'll be using as the encounter. A Sizzlipede, obviously. As you can see, Fly also evolved into a Barrascuda, which I'm hoping to be using here. That doesn't help. That extremely does not help. This is actually quite nerve-wracking now. Okay, Fly switching out. Okay, now I need to get a new Raspberry for Barrascuda. This will be the one we're releasing. Right. Let's give Barrascuda what he needs. I mean, Fly. Let's give Fly what he needs. Of course it's my last Rose Berry. Let's hope we got the Summon Berries just in case. Okay. Here's our official counter. And this is what we'll be taking with us. A Litwick. Do you mind? Yeah, that's not helpful. There we go. Now you think of a good name for a ghostly candle. An animated character that's ghostly. Oh, what's the name of her? Emily the Corpse Bride. No, it's not animated. Why is this extra hard? I'm honestly stuck here. I do know where they're gonna go right now, though. They're gonna replace Funky Kong's spot for the moment. Because it's not a good idea to bring a grass type to this. Unless I'm planning to do Switch in shenanigans. If we're lucky, it could have flash fire. What should the name be? Agatha? No, it's not an anime character. It has to specifically be an animated character. That was the rule set I gave myself. Morgana? No. This is actually kind of frustrating. A female animated character that's either ghostly or... Okay, I've gotten a few ideas now. Maybe not. Emily will do, as in the Corpse Bride. Let's have a look at Emily's stats then. Flame body, that could be helpful in the future. A neutral nature, yeah, I could see some of this using. Yeah, Most Oak Stadium, yeah, right. Now we can just defeat the Vulpix. I've been dreading about this fight all week. Of course. Why is it with this flippin' gym and using up my flippin' raspberries? Wow. Am I actually struggling here? Oof. Good going, Fly. Now we're gonna put a Lumberry on Fly. For the very, very slim chance I would have to bring out Turbo, there. I'm not gonna bring out Luna or Emily either, so. It'll mainly be Fly, Depth Charge, and Rocket carrying the reins for this one. Okay. So first off, we'll start off with Barrasketa dealing with the Ninetales. Then we'll switch to Depth Charge, Dynamax, and then start spraying. I don't know if this will work. I've been dreading this one character all week. Interesting. I might have overthought about it. Now Death Charge has to come in. That's what I was afraid of. That Arcanine's faster than me. Question is, will that Santa Scorch be? Okay, I think we're good. Just gotta get that Santa Scorch now. Just to be clear as well, Gigantamax isn't available for me either, because there's no way to make a Pokemon Gigantamax right now. Too long, boys. Give it everything I've got, Death Charge! Oh, he tanked it. Okay, we're good, we're good, we're good. And that was a crit as well. We did it. I overfought over a gym again. Death Charge MVP for that one.
Sometimes foreshadowing is relatively obvious.
I had to say though, Fly definitely held the beginning for outspeeding the Ninetales. But yeah, I overfought that fight, didn't I? Yeah, the one thing I was told not to do. Just turn off my radio, don't worry. That could be useful. Alright, now we're out of there. Let's actually sort around the team a bit. Because we don't need to really go against fire types as much now. It'd be good to have a poison fighting type around. I do need to release the Sense Scorch, the Sizzlipede though. Hey Okira, how you doing? You feeling any better? We just finished the third gym. And I kind of overthought about it again. And we've just caught this. And if you're wondering, Emily is as in the Corpse Bride. You know, like, the Corpse Bride was named Emily, wasn't it? It's got nothing to do with your allergies, is it? Yeah, it kind of got really bad. I'm just trying to sort out the overlay, because now I've adjusted the team a bit. Okay. Well, just as long as it's not sending you back to the hospital for the third time. That's the last thing we need right now. You are not going back as far as you can tell them. Just hoping you get to try out the beta for Monster Hunter Wilds before it ends. Alright, now I just need to change Turbo into Froppy. I see like a dark red for the fighting type. Like that. Hey, if you're up for it after I'm done, might be able to show you how it works. There are a few new implementations. Let me just... I need to see if I've gotten Krogunk's thing. It doesn't look like I do, so I'm going to quickly install it. Do you want me to go through all of the Pokemon's nicknames, just in case you don't understand? Because some of them are a bit obscure, I'll say. But I've had to dig deep. The female version of Krogunk. And then we can get our next encounter then. I'll say though, it is fun. It's really fun. The new beta. Okay, new gym done, new Pokemon with Emily. And now we're gonna head into the wild area. Let me know if you give up on one or two, because I'll say no. There are two that I know you won't get. And by the way, the story's not being concerned, so I'm just skipping the list. Lesbian trap on the right. So you went, eh. Which one, the old one or the ginger one? By the way, this guy is called Espresso Depresso. You know, hop. The old one? No, oh, hop is Espresso Depresso. Bead is ignorable. In fact, it might be showing why he's called Espresso Depresso this episode. Alright, so back to the uniqueness of my Nuzlocke. Now that we've beaten the gym, we'll have two new encounters in the wild area. Okay, so for the grass encounter, we got here. For the first time we were here, we got here. Second, here. After we beat the second gym, we were here. I would say we go to the Watchtower Ruins for the fire type encounter. For the third gym's encounter. So basically where that big tower is. I know who you meant, the ginger one. The Watchtower Ruins, there we go. Yeah, that was a firework. They've been going crazy recently. Okay, and basically how this is going to work is I'm just going to cover my eyes and just walk into the grass. And that'll be the roaming encounter. Okay. The roaming encounter will be... No supplies are drifting. Very high level. Ah, not the free shake fake out. This is gonna give the team a lot of experience catching something over this certain amount. Luckily, it's just spamming all the stockpile moves. Spooky. Very on theme with it. Oh, boom, boom, now! If you want to clip that, I'm granted, but... Oh! It went boom boom! Oh! We nearly lost Funky Kong there. I am not in the mental state to lose my starter. I'll take it going boom boom than losing Funky Kong. Like that, like, I don't want it to go that, like that. Oh, that was a heart attack. Okay, roaming encounter's gone. Let's just do the random encounter now. The random encounter will be... a Duskull. We can take a Duskull. Very... very chill. And very low level. Very low level. That was scary. I'm catching a lot of ghost types, and it's just been Halloween. Eh. Alright, what are we nicknaming her? It has to be an animated character that's a female that's related to being a ghost. What's the name of Danny Phantom's girlfriend? Sam, was it? I think it was Sam. Yeah, but she kisses a ghost. I think we'll keep that in the back, though, because that could be very useful if something goes wrong. It's a Dusclops. Get an EV light on that and you've got a tank. Oh, why couldn't have you been in the grass? That would have been nice. Come back! Come back! I want my little pepper boy. Right. Oh yeah, I need to sort out the boxes so the boxed counter is accurate. Okay, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yep. Yeah, these are the encounters I've gotten so far. And yes, I've nicknamed a flippin' Applin Applejack. Don't at me. Sam. Turbo. Fly. If you've ever watched Help, I'm a Fish, you'll get that. And Frost. Okay, let's see if there's any red candies to level up Froppy and Emily. No, we don't. Alright. Alright, let's get moving. Have you been resting up alright then? Obviously everyone's been, thinking about you, Kiro. A certain someone I shall not mention also has been thinking about you, but I think that's kind of obvious. Oh, there's a Thunderstone, that might be useful. Yeah, while we're... Yeah, good. I'm thinking maybe I should watch The Book of Life since it is November 2nd. You know, the Day of the Dead. Día de los Muertos. Good. I'm not saying that you need to be on by then, but it should be good to hear from you, that's all. Do you think your allergic reaction might have been accelerated because of you jumping on the day after you got back? I've never heard anyone ever get an allergic reaction to antibiotics before, though. It was so weird. But in all intents and purposes, though, I'm just glad you're home and you're resting and you're somewhat comfortable. I'm not saying your hospital bed wouldn't have been comfortable, but come on, like, there's a lot of places that you would like rather be other than a hospital bed. That is going to be very useful later if someone still survives. Oh, look at all the flutter boys. Look at all me annoying bats. There is something I need to try and grab as well, because if I get something really good, I mean really good, I could even put away Death Charge. So, have you figured out what a couple of my names are references to? Hey, don't bash at me, dragons. Dragons are cool. Okay, so Luna, as much as you would take to think it'd be from a hell of a boss, it isn't. From what Tori has told me, Luna is the name of one of the Hex Girls from Scooby-Doo. And frankly, that makes a lot of sense for a toxicity for me. Ooh, Vossilized Drake, that's what I wanted. Okay, good. I just need the Vossilized Dino next. There we go. Okay, I actually have something going now. Because this could be really useful. And Death Charge is the name of a transformer that turns into a manta ray. Here, let me get up for you.
Cards come to life. Show off your fave, Shed.
Ignore that. This guy.
He's here. Death Charge. Maximize! Watch your old scanner.
if that isn't a reason to give it to a name for a Gyarados, I don't know what is. And I have the distinction of saying it had to be an animated character, so... Right. I just hope I'm not gonna get flagged by YouTube for having that on. Oh, I really hope I don't get a Maractus later on. That'll be horrible. Oh look, it's Stumpy, or whatever you named your Mudsdale. Oh, that's where a fossilized Drake was. Yeah, so I was right with Stumpy. Flygon, one of my boys! Honestly, I think things are starting to look up with the way my team looks. Apart from them being under-level, not unevolved, they look like they're going to be pretty strong. Yes, yeah, blah, 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 give it to me. Ben BB's on PlayStation at the moment. I really wish there was a way I could do this while still being a hungry Badonga Dunks, but I kind of feel like they'd be against the idea of me doing this while they were here. Alright, so think of something we can talk about, because I'm not gonna lie, there's gonna be not much to talk about whilst I'm going through this. We do have a diverse team, I'm not gonna lie. It's very exciting. Oh, well, Kira, what do you think of my new microphone? What do you think of my new webcam? Like, does it look a bit better? Mainly just down to the fact the old one was actually breaking, so I had no choice but to buy a new one. I've managed to get one of the really good Razer ones though. That's why it's even got an autofocus mode. I do have it on now, but I can't even tell. This is why I think he looks like a knockoff David Beckham. And then what do you think about its secretary? I'm assuming the secretary is a point of focus. There might be something I might need to grab for anything we pick up in the future. Like, things that might involve a friendship evolution. That'll make things look a lot easier. Oh look, it's Espresso Depresso's brother. In fact, before I go any further, I think I'm gonna go and get some extra, like, items. Have I got the right one? I feel like I might have gotten the wrong fossil. Let me see. I need the fossilized fish. I'll sort that out quickly. I need the fossilized fish. No, I didn't get the encounter. So I gotta go back to those digging duos. So there's a sandstorm in this part of the bit. Man, those bagpipes go hard. Fossilized fish. No, I need the fossilized fish. Give me the fossilized fish. Give me the fish. Now the fish. Fish! Just give me the fish! Give me the flippin' Drake then! Give me the Drake so many times! Moonstone. Nothing. Yes, go on, keep going, keep going. Rabone. Are you kidding me? Rabone. Melcoat. Oh, come on. Just give me the fish. I've only got 3 more tries. Two more tries. This is ridiculous. Drake, fuck off. Maybe I should have gone to the other one. I'll try again off camera or something. Hey, my boy. That could have been worse. Whoops. There. That doesn't do much for me. Neither does that. More exposition. Anything else you want to talk about, Kira, if you're still there? While you're here, I've actually been able to catch up with Hell of a Boss all the way up to the new episode that came out a few days ago. a fully leveled Axe Shield. What are you doing that for? Maybe I need to ask you a certain question. I'm sorry. Nah. Have you seen the shorts though? Like, the quick ones. Ah. I feel like watching Fantastic Mr. Fox. Can't lie. Ooh, more of things to sell. Because I'm not going to be using those revives. It's weird playing Monster Hunter with Mike as well, by the way. But it's fun though. It's fun. Alright, let's actually get moving. I didn't buy any items, did I? Okay, so best case scenario in this situation is I get myself an Axe Shoe in this patch of grass coming up. Cause you know me, I like my dragon types. And it's a Haxorus, like come on, like what isn't there to like about Haxorus? Alright. Oh, I'm not sure if it'll show, but I got a new Pro Controller for my Switch. Look what's in it. There you go, there's the autofocus working. Alright, let's do this, Froppy. Okay. Oh, nuts. It's not safe for me to keep Froppy out here. Also, the Rocket's been amazing. Rocket has actually been amazing so far. Watch how bulky is Stunky. At least it's ended a lot better last time something spammed bite at me. Oh, Aftermath, okay. I'm sure Funky Kong could deal with a flippin' lightning. Of course. Okay, you won't survive that. This is dangerous, actually. Whoa, back down there. That's a death, damn it. I couldn't risk losing Dev Charge there. No, Rocket! Oh, crap, no. I don't know what to do now. Oh, you got greedy. Rocket was a bad one. This was my fault for not leveling up. I'm not even done yet either. Okay. I'm gonna have to use that one heal per Pokemon for this, if I'm gonna survive this. Stop spamming that, you're not clever. I don't want to go any further until I've caught up to level 30. Oh, that was my fault. We lost flippin' Rocket. Rocket was gonna help against the Ghost Gym. Why is it me losing Pokemon? I think will really be really helpful during the next gym. Yeah, go and run off Cripe for the Depresso Espresso. Okay, yeah. Honestly, I think Rocket was the first major death. I was actually starting to get attached to Rocket. It's gonna look really funny in the Fibbin YouTube video, though. Oh, Rocket. I really nearly lost that then. It could have been a lot worse than what it did. I still don't know what to do about that Gengar. I'm sorry, mate. I should have been a bit more careful. Right. I'll take Sam for now. In fact, I'll change its name. I know. Danny as in Danny with an I, yeah. Oh, that was painful. Right. Let's go get our next encounter on Route 6 and pray it enacts you. Okay, our next encounter will be a battle. Never mind. Oh, this is that train that spams flipping metronome. Does that make me a ghost, fire, and grass type? Okay, you don't have anything stored, so... Don't you land that. No! No. Okay. Well done, Emily. First kill. I'm not messing around with Clefable. So if this thing just sprouts out flipping the Thunderbolt, I'm not gonna be happy. Okay. That's good. Why do I still have tackle on this? Okay, we've been lucky. We've been lucky. Alright, let's go and heal back. And then we'll get our encounter. Kira. You still there? You still being up Axews? Good. Because I think I need a power cleanser and I just lost Rocket and Froppy. And I'm just on edge. And Rocket was going to be my counter for the Ghost Gym. Okay, my next encounter will be... a Helioptile? Oh. There's so many good encounters on this route. Axew, Glaring Yamask, Dugtrio. But I can see a use in this. Yeah, I can see a use in this. Let's try that. Really? This could save me. Stop breaking out! Jinx. I'll name it Jinx. Them. Right, let's go back and grind a bit now that I've gotten Jinx. There we go. There's been a lot of Heliolisks in my life recently. Really bad nature, jolly. For now, we're gonna go back into the wild area and grind up a bit. Hey Kira, you seen Scottish Ben's little competition thing, by the way? If in any case that you can't, would you like the idea if maybe I claimed the Shadow Plush and then sent it to you. It seems like the only fair thing in my eyes. Especially if you couldn't compete because you were still resting up. You already have that plushie. Never mind then. Not really. Is there anything in that list of things you would like me to claim if you couldn't make it? Gloom has a reputation for roofing people. This is exactly why I did what I do in Nuzlocke in the first place, because I'm still feeling upset about losing Rocket. I'm hoping I can get that Megatron figure, frankly. Above all that though, I'm just wondering, why is he spending money on things he's planning to give to us on his own birthday? Very strong looking Gengar. By how much? Okay, bye bye. Uh-oh. Death Charge, no! I just lost my strongest member to a... Oh my god, I'm an idiot! Well, I now know what I'm gonna be evolving that Eevee into. Thank you. Oh, I was hoping Death Charge would make it to the end. Biggest Dell I've ever had. I don't know. That was the worst thing that could have happened. Well, yeah, I've got to use that Eevee as a Vaporeon now. It might be a bulkier option, but it's more of a case of I have no choice. Barrascute is not bulky enough. This is why I kept it in the. This is why I kept that Eevee in the back for if that ever happened, like the worst case scenario. This is honestly not looking good. Like, my strongest team members are dwindling. I need to stop taking risks like this. That Gengar messed me up badly. I thought it'd be like maybe level 40 and maybe I could risk it. And then I couldn't get away from running from it. That was my fault though. I'm being so stupid today. Kinda symbolic. I'll use these dens to grind up for that one, so that doesn't happen again. Honestly, I really feel bad now, because I have lost so many good team members now. Rocket and Death Charge were amazing. And then one little cock up like that ruins it. I did not have flamethrower TM for Emily. There we go. Right, I'm gonna get these guys up to level 30 and then we'll continue on. Dizzy. All these deaths are driving me crazy. Ooh, bad idea. Sorry. This is the most deaths I've had yet on this Nuzlocke. Okay, that's Luna evolving into Toxtricity. That will be useful. Spark. All this leveling up is what's taking the time. catching it, not catching it. I'm not catching any Dynamax Pokemon. That could be useful. Just to be clear, since this is a public raid, I'm gonna say if anything dies, that doesn't count as a death. Because you don't know what's gonna happen here. But this will give me enough XP candies to level up for sure. Everything great about The Nightmare Before Christmas. Yes, there's lots of good things about that film. That Weavile would fix so much problems with me right now, but it would be kind of cheating if I did hit this up. Yeah, this is why I said I was not going to involve deaths in raids, because it gets too erratic to make a decision on if it'll work or not. So this is going to be the exception. Time now. Thank you. See, there you go. That'll be enough. Also, Darkest Lariat might be able to help with the gym. See, Jinx is still alive, so that doesn't count. Right, before I do, like, this has happened before, so I'm saying before we continue, I'm gonna save before I do it because I don't want to overlevel. I'm probably overthinking a lot of things right now. That will do. Let's get back on the road then. There isn't much here, is there? No. Okay. Let's go. We're fully trained up now, we're all leveled up. So there should be any more problems. See, what happened if that would have happened when I came around earlier? That would have been amazing.
Hmm.
That is to be expected. I would have loved to get this. I think I might have an idea on what to do about something. I just caught the big dark crystal type from Scarlet. I don't get what you mean by that. Oh, death charge. I didn't even know why I did that. Oh, right, you're doing the terror raids. Frankly, Kira, I think I'm just on edge after just losing so no. I didn't know that I had to fight. Can I just stop making mistakes? Oh, thank God. Look, can I just stop ruining things for myself? Okay, maybe I should just stop using Ruby from now on, like, whilst we're in this area. I actually feel kind of on edge for every fight now, of course. Of course. Right. Let me vol switch. That's why pivoting moves are good moves. Huh? You can't hit me, can you? Well, I got a shiny for alligator. Honestly, every fight feels like a stress fest. Dig. That could help. Like clay. Oh god, that's a real trap. Okay, I've got no choice but to catch this, because I'm in trouble now. I'll instantly release it. That was the only plan I could think of to get. Oh god, I can't take this anymore. I've lost 4 Pokemon in one stream today. I can't take it. Asgard. I can take this one. Hey, Luna dealt with a Polignard before. Good, good. This guy will start off with a coughing. This guy's just creepy. He would have hit me with assurance then, so... It likes to get rid of stat changes. Donkey Kong can handle this one. There. We've made it to the stone side. With a lot of casualties. It's not the strongest dig user, but I need a dig user. Side. That will be useful in a while. Alright, we're just gonna beat Hop and then we're gonna finish there. Like, there's been too much heartbreak this episode. Also, there's one other thing I want to check as well. that might save us. I know I can do it. Icy Wind. I think Protect is too reliable not to get rid of. Yes, very nice. Moving on. Right. Well, my thing sorts out, and I'll finish off then. This counts as a static encounter, so it won't count for the Glimwood Tangle. So, we've got full claim over this Impidimp. This Impidimp might save us. Aurora Beam, that'll be useful. What animated character is male character that's known for having long hair? I kind of want to say a fun name would be Bayonetta, but obviously that would only work for a female Pokemon like a Hatterene. King. And that really hurt my wrist clicking. Oh, it doesn't have Prankster, damn it. Yeah, King. You remember what a Grimmsnarl looks like? No, it's covered in black fur. Well, hair in Impidimp's case. But yeah, this counts as a static encounter, so... yeah, Bat King. Well, what other characters do you know that are male and have lots of hair? That'll be the last thing we do today, though, because you saw the massacre today. I'm just hoping that Impidimp evolves very quickly into a Morgrim. Because this gym is going to be hard now that we've lost all of my counters towards it. We'll do the proper Glimmer Tangle encounter next time. Not the best roster of Pokemon, is it? Yeah, let me just check what level Impidimp evolves into Morgrim, and then we'll finish up. Oh, so one level. Let's see if we can quickly do that now. Yeah, we'll do a raid or something. Now we're still inside, we can easily just fast travel. It still won't be faster than Alistair's Gengar, but just a dark type in general helps a lot. Simple. I need to double check what level Alistair's Pokemon are as well. What I have currently, this is going to be a tough fight, even with Morgrim. There we go. More Graham wants to learn false surrender. The user pretends to bow its head, but then it stabs the target with its disabled hair. This attack never misses. Oh. Sucker Punch might be my way out of this. Okay. I'll do that. I'll do the rest of the grinding off camera again. But yeah. There's a lot riding on this, so. Oof. No pressure. But of course, that'll be it for today. I need to regrow my brain cells before I lose them again. Yeah, unfortunately, obviously, we have lost a lot of value team members today. Obviously, that being mainly Rocket and Depth Charge. Two really great members. And I wish they had more of a chance to shine. Makes sense. But yeah, I am sorry for all those Gyarados and Linoon fans out there that I have distrusted today. But yeah, that will be it for today's episode. If you liked the chaos and the misery, please consider liking and subscribing. We'll be getting out more of these episodes of the Nuzlocke every Saturday. And every Friday we shall try to either do something multiplayer related with the rest of the community, or something shiny hunting related. I would normally also do playthrough stuff on Monday, but at the moment I've been trying to keep that open for emergencies because of family issues. But I might be able to try and get that back on the norm soon, so keep looking out for that. But apart from that, thank you all for watching. I hope you had a good day. Kira, I hope you have a very, very fast resting period. We all miss you. And above all else, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time. See ya.